Good evening, everyone. I welcome you all to the orientation of the Legal Aid Society of Campus Law Center. My name is Misbah. I'm the student convener of the society. Today I have with me Vinayak, Lavika, and Raghav, who are the student co-conveners of the society. We also have Vasudha with us, who is the editor-in-chief of Awaaz, the official blog of the Legal Aid Society. We are here to give you a detailed information about the workings of the society. We at the Legal Aid Society are very excited to share with you about all the activities, and we really look forward to your active and enthusiastic participation. Before we get into a detailed presentation, I will just tell you a little bit about the society. For those who would have attended the orientation organized by the teacher convener, Dr. Shidit Singh, you would have gotten all of this information, but just a brief overview. So the Legal Aid Society primarily works to help in providing legal aid to people who are unable to afford legal representation and access to the court system. So the society conducts various legal awareness activities and runs a legal aid clinic, which works in collaboration with the Delhi State Legal Services Authority. The clinic aims to provide free legal counsel and services to all those who fall under Section 12 of the Legal Services Authorities Act. As budding lawyers, it's imperative that we understand the need and importance of pro bono services. As law students and those interested in the Legal Aid Society, it's also a good opportunity for you to look at the Legal Services Authorities Act and familiarize yourself with the law on legal aid in India. This is just some very basic and important information. To participate in the activities of the Legal Aid Society, students can either be registered members of the society or they can be paralegal volunteers. It is imperative for all interested students to register as members through the registration link that we will be providing shortly after this orientation program. To be paralegal volunteers, students have to be registered members. So in order for you to sit for the paralegal volunteer training, you have to first be registered members. So do ensure that you fill the link that we do provide after this orientation ends. So while some activities of the society are exclusively open for paralegal volunteers, there are a lot of activities that are open for all registered members of the society. So irrespective of whether you do end up becoming a paralegal volunteer, there are great merits to being a registered member of the society. So to talk about the structure of the society and a little bit on the formalities, I give it over to Raghav to introduce you to it. Raghav?
Yeah, all right. Thank you, Misbah. And good evening, everyone present here. My name is Raghav. I am present here in the capacity of co-convener of the society. In my part of the orientation, I'll be covering the structural aspects of the society and process of admission to the society. Now, starting with the structure of society, starting from the top, we have Professor in charge of CLC as our patron in chief, followed by Dr. Shidit Singh as our faculty teacher convener. And then we have following teachers as our faculty members, as you can see in the presentation. Now, moving on to the next slide. To head the society and manage its affairs, we have an executive body consists of students from both second year and third year, which is headed and coordinated by a student co-convener, and a limited number of co-conveners. Also, to be the member of executive committee, a student needs to be a PLV force. Moving on to the next slide, Misbah. Let me brief you about the strength and composition of members. Referring to the data from last year, there were total 652 registrations from first year only, out of which 90 students were qualified as PLVs and 560 students were non-PLVs. Moving on, next slide. So now, moving on to who are paralegal volunteers and how does a student become a PLV. Now, paralegal volunteers are intermediaries that bridge the gap between the common people and the legal services institutions to remove the impediments in access to justice. In order to be a paralegal volunteer, students have to undergo a 2-day training session, which is conducted by the Delhi State Legal Service Authority. At the end of the training session, they are given PLV ID cards and are registered with their respective DLS. To undergo the training, students are selected solely on the basis of a written examination conducted by the society. Now, to appear for the exam, a student has to be a LAS member first. The procedure of selection was followed till last year. This process of selection was followed till last year, but owing to restrictions in reopening of the colleges due to COVID-19, society may opt for some alternate methods, which, if devised, will be convened later on. Now, only 130 students are selected to undergo the training session. And last year, it was out of 130 students, 90 students were from first year and 40 students were from second year. Now, moving on, next slide. Now, coming to the next slide. This is how physically exams are conducted. And these are the photos from training session. These are the photos from training session last year. Now, coming to the general rules and regulations. Now, general rules and regulations of the society. Now, to be the part of LAS, it is mandatory to fill the LAS membership registration form, which will be available on our social media platforms shortly after this orientation, as Misbah has told. Information provided in the registration form should be true and accurate. Once completely, only completely filled forms are accepted as valid registrations for the society. Legal Aid Society will not disclose the information received from any member of the society to any other person except to the authorities, including NALSA, DALSA, and DSLS, and any other organization with which society coordinates. There is no registration fees to be paid by the members willing to register themselves with the society. For activities, selection is mostly based on first-come, first-served basis. There are other modes of selection also, like skill test, knowledge of law involved, and previous participation in the society activities. Methods of selection varies with different kinds of activities taken up. Now, there are certain acts. Next slide. Yeah. Thank you. Now, there are certain acts for which you can get debarred from the society. For instance, if any student deliberately provides any false information, or any student who registers for an activity and does not appear for it, as well as does not report in advance. Before unbecoming the member of the society, a chance of fair hearing is given to the student. If any dispute arises, the decision of the teacher convener is final and is binding. Now, this was from my side. And now my fellow co-conveners, Vinayak Goyal and Lavika Jaiswal, will tell you about the activities that are previously picked up by the society. Thank you.
Thank you, Raghav. Hello. Vinayak Goyal is here in the capacity of student co-convener of the Legal Aid Society. I will tell you briefly about the practical part of the Legal Aid Society that consistently runs through, that is Legal Aid Clinic. Legal Aid Clinic was inaugurated in 2014 by former Justice A.K. Sikri of Supreme Court of India. Next slide, Misbah. The clinic provides free legal aid and assistance to the people, to the marginalized sections of the society. It used to be open from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. every Saturday. An advocate appointed by the Central District Legal Services Authority, who used to be present every Saturday to deal with the public. Paralegal volunteers are also present during the clinic hours to assist the lawyer to draft applications and for follow-ups, in which they have to maintain the register who has come to the clinic, which what advice the lawyer has given to him or her, and what follow-up has been taken by the Legal Aid Society. So a proper register has to be maintained in the Legal Aid Clinic by the paralegal volunteers appointed on that respective Saturdays. Next, the thing that paralegal volunteers do every Saturday there is to assist the lawyer, and second, to help the people to go to the nearest court or to the court of their jurisdiction. In this regard, a form used to be released for every Saturday, a day or 2 days prior to every Saturday, so that students are selected on first-come, first-served basis. And students are selected for different time periods, like for 10 to 10:30, 10:30 to 11:30, and so on, so that we can cover up maximum students of maximum maximum PLPs. This is all we, in regard to legal aid clinic. Now I would request Ms. Lavika to tell you all about activities and institutional visits. Thank you.
Thank you, Vinayak. Good evening, everyone. I'm Lavika Jaiswal, and I'll be discussing the kind of activities that are organized by Legal Aid Society and what is the role of volunteers. For the convenience, we have demarcated the activities into four categories. The first category is the awareness drives. Legal Aid Society, when they organize it, the major objective of an awareness drive is to inform people about free legal services provided by DSLSA. We also aim to make them aware of the benefits available to them under law. It is also to spread legal literacy and awareness about legal and social issues. Through these drives, the students are made to look into ground realities of various social problems of the people. These kind of drives are basically organized to instill a sense of civic, a civic sense and responsibility among the residents of the concerned area and make them aware of the recourses they can take if they are facing any issue. Next slide. So these are some examples of the legal aid activities that are organized in the name of awareness drives. So there was a legal aid drive, a legal awareness drive, which was organized in Timarpur, including in Indra Basti and Sanjay Basti. Then there was this clean and green march at Daryaganj, which spoke about basically not burning the crackers. And also this march was focusing on promoting the burning of green crackers, and people also took pledge in this drive. There was this drug de-addiction awareness drive in Christian Colony. And these are that you can see. Moving to next slide. These are some pictures. Then the second category of the legal aid activities is the door-to-door campaigns and legal aid help desks. What volunteers can expect from this are the following things. Prior to the on-site visit, the volunteers are briefed about the purpose of the drive and are acquainted with the basic information and all the precautionary measures to be taken. Briefing usually takes place at college only, and sometimes volunteers are asked to reach the site directly. On the day, the volunteers go from door to door creating awareness about the legal aid services provided by DSLSA for various sections of the society. And the people in the neighborhood are informed when and where they can avail these services and are explained the procedure in the simplest way as possible. The volunteers are often required to fill in a response sheet as well. Moving to next slide, these are some examples. Where Legal Aid Society, the kind of door-to-door campaign that Legal Aid Society has organized. Legal Aid Camp for Riot Victims in Karawal Nagar and Shivvihar was organized by us. And there was this rescue drive in New Delhi, Railway Station and Connaught Place. Rest you can have a look at it. Moving to next slide. This gives you an idea what exactly you do, how you interact with people. And the picture in the right corner is about, it was an online campaign which was organized during a pandemic, during the pandemic, yes, during the lockdown. Now moving to next slide. The third category is visits. The volunteers through drives like these gives volunteers a profound understanding of life within a jail or other correctional institutions. In this process, they also realize how legal aid can fill the systematic and structural gaps that exist in the system. The volunteers get to acquaint themselves with the realities and practical application of the idea of justice. The volunteers are briefed about the historical backgrounds of various acts. Depends what kind of drive is it and what is the objective of the drive. And selection is based on participation in the society. Students will be informed of the selection criteria in advance. Moving to next slide, these are some categories of visits that were organized. Legal Aid Society has visited to Tihar Jail Complex, Manduli Jail Complex, and Juvenile Justice Board. We have also participated in National Lok Adalat. When it will be organized, you will be informed about it. Moving to next slide. Next. The fourth category is seminars and webinars. Legal Aid Society has also organized film screening as well. Now, these kind of activities, these sessions are majorly organized to take the students, to make the students aware of the academic background of an issue, to make them familiar with practical experiences of the activist, giving way to discussions and reaching an understanding to a variety of issues of current importance and students' interest. Moving to next slide. As you can see that we have organized seminar on UN Human Rights Council and human rights lawyering in India. Then there was a seminar on copyright law and the feminist gaze. So these varies with semester to semester. So this is all from my end. And now I welcome Vasudha to talk about another domain of Legal Aid Society. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Lavika. Hi, I'm Vasudha and I'm in third year. I'm the editor-in-chief of Awaaz, which is the official blog of the Legal Aid Society. You can find us at lasclc.in, the URL which is displayed on your screen right now. And on the website, you would find an extensive description of the thought process behind starting this blog. You can also find the articles posted so far and the submission guidelines. The site also hosts all the information you require about the Legal Aid Society, the Legal Services Clinic, the upcoming events of the society, and all the recent notices. They are all available on the website. We also have a separate section for the publications of the Legal Aid Society. These include the e-newsletters as well as the annual Legal Aid Society report. This site would be unavailable for some time tonight for maintenance, but it'll be back up soon. Next slide, please. So moving on to Awaaz, this project was launched in January 2020. The Legal Aid Society has been working untiringly for the marginalized sections of the society. So we thought that parallel to this, a need was felt to have a platform to present diverse viewpoints regarding socio-economic and political issues and analyze them in a legal framework. So we felt that students and readers would benefit a lot from an interdisciplinary approach to legal education. And it has been an attempt to publish pieces that place social issues within the matrix of strong legal analysis. And with this initiative, we aim to foster a culture of research and academic writing in CLC. So far, we have received 153 submissions, and these have been from law schools across India. We have published 9 pieces so far. Next slide, please. So apart from the blog, the editorial board of Awaaz also publishes an e-newsletter of the Legal Aid Society. This is published twice a year, contains reports on all the drives, seminars, and other activities that have been described of the Legal Aid Society. It also includes articles by members of the editorial board, as well as interviews with reputed personalities from the field of law. It also has a section on recent judgments by the Supreme Court and the High Courts on constitutional law and legal aid. Next slide, please. So as you can see, Awaaz also organizes events such as panel discussion and seminars on topics of relevance. So far, we have organized a seminar on human rights lawyering in India and a webinar on judicial responsibility in enforcing second and third generation rights. Here, we were honored to have Honorable Ms. Justice Geeta Mittal as a keynote speaker. Next slide, please. So on the screen, you can see some responsibilities of the editorial board of Awaaz. These are reviewing and deciding whether an article can be published or not, copy editing, writing articles, editorial and research work for e-newsletters, handbooks, etc. of the Legal Aid Society, as well as ideating and holding events of different kind. So currently we have a team of 5 editors, 1 senior editor, 1 managing editor, and me. We would be opening up applications for the editorial board next semester. So I encourage everyone who's interested to apply. So in order to be selected, you have to be proficient in written English. You must be someone who pays attention to the finest of details. and you must have an interest in contemporary issues and the legal aspects. As for the technical details, you should be a registered member of the Legal Aid Society, but it is not necessary to be a paralegal volunteer. So since we have a few months before we would be selecting the editorial board, what you can do in the meantime is visit the website and read the articles that we have published so far. And also, if you're interested in applying, it would be beneficial to stay up to date on current affairs. You can keep reading articles by lawyers, legal scholars, and also participate in debates and discussions about various issues with your peers. And if you write something, we encourage you to please submit your piece to us so that we may publish it. And if you have any doubts, you can approach any of the members of the editorial board and also any of the members of the Legal Aid Society. So all the best for your time at CLC, and I hope you'll join us in making a vast success. Thank you. Over to Ms. Pa. Ms.
Ma,
just unmute yourself, please.
Thank you. So thank you, Vasudha. Just at the end of our presentation, just to give a recap of what happened in the last session, the year 2020 was tough for all of us, though tougher for some people more than the others. We were in the middle of providing legal relief to riot victims in Northeast Delhi when the lockdown was announced. We were all confined to our homes and we had to step back and rethink about our activities. We had to ideate on ways we can still help people around us. Our seniors came up with the idea that we could help in providing ration to those who needed it in that period. So we created a team of dedicated paralegal volunteers who were helping in providing the e-coupons for the online ration scheme that had been enrolled by the Delhi government. These included migrant workers, laborers, construction workers, and riot victims. Other than that, we also assisted in the legal aid help desk that had been organized for the e-coupons. We organized a few seminars and we have been invested in creating research papers, including a handbook on domestic violence laws in India. Now, the road ahead is something that we are expecting from all of you. What exactly is it that you as first years can help us in, and how can we together work towards legal aid and making the society achieve its goal? So firstly, you can help us by increasing the number of activities and initiatives, which include research papers, help us conduct surveys, and help us in preparation of the various reports that we do work on. You can help us by enriching the diversity of the activities, by including various emerging issues and practical issues of current relevance. You can also help us enhance our public outreach of our society, of the clinic, and the work that we do. As a society, we do aim to train more students as paralegal volunteers so that there can be an increased participation in all DSLSA activities and initiatives. The main aim of the society and what we do envision is to provide assistance to those who are the most vulnerable sections of the society. While primarily the goal is to create legal awareness, but also provide legal assistance in whatever capacity that we can. And in this time, specifically given that we all are at our homes, we won't be coming to college, we also have to create and think of novel ideas to reach out to people, to help people so that they do have access to justice, even in COVID times. I'm at the end of the presentation. This would be a good time for everyone to ask their questions. You can post your questions in comments on the Facebook Live itself, and we're all here to respond to them. In case you have any queries, any confusion, clarification that you require. Ideally, this would have happened in college and we would have had a chance to interact with you even after the orientation would have ended. We would have interacted between classes. So and definitely there would have been better information dissemination, but unfortunately it's not possible right now. So any queries that you may have, you can post on the Facebook live right now. While you do that, because we won't be coming to college, at least for the next few months, it would be good for all interested first-year students to follow us on our social media handles. So we are on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. And as Vasudha had already explained to you, we also have a website. So we post all our notifications, notices, information about recent activities and upcoming activities on all our social media platforms. So it would be good for you to follow all of these or any one of them as per your convenience. Sagar, is there any question that I can respond to or anyone here can? Okay, how can we get in this society? As I had explained in the beginning itself, for first year students, as soon as the orientation program ends, we will be releasing a notice on all our social media handles. It will be a Google form, so just register yourself with the society and through that form, you will be registered members of the society, and then all information will be coming to you once you are registered members of the society to participate in any activity of the society, including the PLV exam, sitting for the PLV exam or the training, or to participate in any awareness drive visit. You have to be a registered member of the society. So do fill the form and register yourself with the society, because if you're not a registered member of the society, you cannot participate in any event that we organize in the future. So the registration link will be provided as soon as this program ends. How do you prepare for the PLV exam? So information on the PLV exam will be circulated once we are closer to conducting the exam. As Raghav had mentioned, we've been conducting PLV exams before, but because of the pandemic, we've given online exams for our semesters as well. So we aren't really sure about the feasibility of conducting a PLV exam in this semester, but on any information that do comes up, we will let you know, and which will also include how you can prepare for the PLB exam and what all would be expected of first year students. If you are already associated with the DSLSC as PLB, then that's great. You can work with them with your allotted district and participate in their activities, but you still have to be a member of the society to participate in any event or activity that we as a society organize. And if you are already a PLB, then you would not be sitting for the training session, because that's for those who aren't PLBs. So how many times in a year PLV exam takes place? So we only conduct a PLV exam once a year, because there's a training that happens once a year only. You can either take it in your first year, but if you don't qualify, you can still take the PLV exam and you can sit for the PLV training session in your second year as well. So it's fine if you don't qualify in the second year. In your first year, you still have your second year for it. So so while you're in college, I think it'll be twice that you can take the exam. What are the advantages of being a PLV member over a non-PLV member? So as I'd mentioned, there are some activities of the society that would be open exclusively for PLVs. This would include sitting at the legal aid clinic and assisting the lawyer, the impaneled lawyer who comes to the clinic. going for some drives would be specifically only for PLV members. Visits that Lavika had mentioned would only be open to PLVs. There are some that are exclusively for PLV, so you would only be eligible for them. But otherwise, we try to ensure that there's an equal representation of both PLVs and non-PLVs in most of our activities. So even if you don't become a PLV or aren't able to qualify the exam, you can still participate in the activity. Again, so for the PLV exam, we will be telling you later when there is more clarity on when it will be conducted. But as of now, there's not much that I can tell you. Again, so the registration link will be provided as soon as this program ends. You can see the Facebook page of the Legal Aid Society. We are also on Twitter with the handle LAS_CLC and on Instagram as well. We're called Legal Aid Society CLC. Okay, there's a question on Awaz. Vasudha, would you want to respond to that?
Yes, how to join Awaz editorial board. So we have a process by which we invite applications for Awaz, and then we have stages where, for example, last time what we did was first you have to send in a writing sample, and then you have to send in an editing sample, and then the final stage is an interview. So it's different every time, but there's some stages to go through, and then finally we decide the people who would join the editorial board. So you would get more information on this when we decide to open the applications for us. Thank you.
I just want to clarify one thing. Since there was a question regarding already being a PLV, it would be good for us that when you do apply for the PLV exam or whatever information that comes out for the PLV training session, if you're already a PLV or if you have been a PLV, do inform us and let us know in advance. Even if you don't fill the form, if you are a registered member of the society, do send us an email informing us on whether you, on if you are a PLV. It would be good for us to maintain a record of that and probably share more information on PLV activities that do come our way. Sagar, anything else? I think that's about it for now. If anyone has more queries and you're not able to put them in the comments right now, you can message us on any of our social media platforms. You can also send us an email on our email ID, as you can see on the screen, legalaidsociety@clc.du.ac.in. For any queries, any concerns, any clarifications that you may have regarding today's presentation or otherwise about the society or regarding any other work. So you can send us your queries. You can also contact any one of us in the executive board of the society or anyone who is a part of Awaz and the editorial board, who will be able to guide you and help you on your clarifications and your concerns. Again, I'm reiterating, this would have been a lot more feasible and it would have been a lot more interactive had this been in college, but unfortunately this is happening virtually and we're not able to interact as well as we would have otherwise. But irrespective, I do hope that you all participate in the society's activities. You do register yourself. And I'm again saying that the registration link will be out as soon as this orientation program ends. So you can see either our Facebook page, Instagram, or Twitter, or website to find the notice where you can register yourself. And again, it's extremely important to fill the form if you want to be part of the society. We're also open to any ideas on initiatives, activities that you might want to work on with us. So you can send us an email and we'd be happy to take that up with you. I think that's about it for now. I'm looking forward to interacting with all of you as we move ahead in this semester. If there's anything you want to talk to us about, you can always contact us. And I think that's about it. Good luck for your time at Campus Law Center. And I do hope that you have a great time, as Vasudha has already mentioned. Good luck and thank you for joining us in today's orientation program.